The definition of criticism is, and I quote, an analysis and judgment of the merits and faults of a literary or artistic work. For criticism to be valid, it must bow to the altar of objectivity in order to be taken seriously. Contrary to popular belief, criticism should never be subjective when being formulated into an analysis. The definition of subjective is, and again, word for word, based on or influenced by personal feelings, tastes, or opinions. I don't know about you, but I could care less about what a professional's tastes are. I'd much rather they give me their letter grade than bombard me with the usual art is subjective mantra. What you personally get out of art is subjective, yes, but if you're here to critique, it's time to do your job. I prefer my criticism to be objective because objectivity is truth. Being objective is honest, and being objective is analyzing the situation and providing a case-closed answer. It's the opposite of subjectivism, defined as not being influenced by personal feelings or opinions in considering and representing facts. What does all of this have to do with Bryce Dallas Howard's high heels in Jurassic World? Well, to get to the point, everything. I'm going to be completely honest and upfront with you and start out by saying, the moment Claire lights the flare, lures out the T-Rex, and runs like hell towards the Indominus is by far my favorite moment of Jurassic World. It's presented in a way that's both grand and oddly subtle. The slow steps of the old Rex stomping out of its enclosure, the rise of Giacchino's powerful score, and the terror that's being built by Owen and Zack attempting to prevent Gray from being pulled out of their hiding place by the talons of the Indominus. It's shot, lit, scripted, and acted in a way that makes it undeniably memorable. And dare I say, intelligent. The audience applauded all 5 times I saw the movie in the theater, and most of them continue to do so to this very day. That hasn't stopped criticism from seeping its way into this particular cinematic moment. Oh, how frequently I've heard the complaints of how unlikely it would be for a woman to outrun a Tyrannosaurus in high heels. Oh, how that hasn't been memed into cliché territory. If you can't tell yet, I can't take that criticism seriously. The main reason being the fact that it's built on confirmation bias and a loose understanding of, well, everything that's happening within that scene. Number 1, go back to the start where Claire Dearing has Paddock 9 opened and the Tyrannosaur walks out of the shadows. Even though this is the same Rex from the first movie, and as such would be a considerably old animal, I am not going to use that as ammo for this video. The reason being, not everyone was aware of this being Jurassic Park's T-Rex. Plus, it'd be just too damn easy. I'm also not going to use any of the new scientific evidence that's been reported of the Rex only being able to run 12 miles per hour. Firstly, because the Jurassic Park Rex can factually run up to 32 miles per hour as stated in the first movie. Secondly, because the paleontological studies surrounding Tyrannosaur speed flip-flop back and forth constantly. Give it a few years, they'll say it was a runner again. No, the actual answer to this question is way less complicated and actually represented on screen for the entire world to see. Once Giacchino's music flares up and Claire turns to run, the Tyrannosaur bends its head down to roar and begins to take a few steps. Go back and watch the steps this animal takes out of its paddock. Specifically, at the very moment that she roars, you can see and hear her take a few steps forward without the animal actually speeding up. No, in fact, the animal actually continues going at the same rate of motion. Even at the moment where it bellows and looks like it's beginning to take off, pay attention to the legs. The dinosaur actually takes a measly 2 slow-ass steps forward before it cuts away to the Indominus. The next time you see it following Claire is in slow motion, with the emphasis being given to her high heels. Remember that for an important moment coming up. But before I get to that, I'd like to draw your attention to the Rex's feet in the background. Claire is still in full-on sprint while the Tyrannosaur is still lumbering its way towards her. This leads all the way up until the part where she tosses the flare and it bursts through the Spinosaurus skeleton. If this isn't getting through to you, I'll just go ahead and spell it out. Claire outran the T-Rex because the T-Rex didn't run. If you objectively look at that film and actually watch the movie, you can observe that the T-Rex stayed the course and simply walked. Bryce Dallas Howard ran in high heels, something that is actually plausible and consistent with reality. The T-Rex did not run after the flare, something that's actually consistent with the original Jurassic Park, where it pursues Malcolm, who drunkenly moves towards the toilet. In fact, in that movie, this same Rex didn't actually begin to speed up until after Ian tossed it. Remember, in these films, the T-Rex can only see you if you move. While it was infatuated with the flare, it was hunting Dr. Malcolm. And even in that movie, it only sped up for 3 steps once it threw his body through the building. Hey, check that out. Do you know you can see him fly through the air? Cool shot. Now, if we go back to Jurassic World, that emphasis in slow motion on the high heels is actually deliberate. In fact, it harkens back to an older film similar to the way The Lost World does in its final act. They actually share the exact same movie that they're paying tribute to. If you know your films, you should have caught onto it once Trevorrow showed this to the audience on the big screen. If you don't know why Claire is lying in this position and why she made this trek amongst dinos with very feminine attire, I'd like to introduce you to a little movie that came out in 1933 starring Fay Wray. It's called King Kong. Referencing older dinosaur films has become a staple of Jurassic Park since the very beginning, and it's honestly no different here. So yeah, that's pretty much it. High heels or not, I think it'd be relatively easy for all of us to outrun an animal if it walked, wouldn't you say? Now, of course, I'm aware that some may still try to criticize the film for not providing an answer as to how she was able to navigate the jungle in those high heels. Honestly, I don't know. But I sincerely hope you find the answer to that question. While you're at it, let me know why Timmy had to shut a door that was already closed. Bottom line, your enjoyment of film may be subjective, but don't try to start an argument without a foot planted firmly in facts. Stay objective, my friends. Now, before I go, I want to thank my game wardens, as well as all of my InGen executives. I'd also like to thank my park workers and InGen hunters as well. It means the world to me that you guys appreciate what I do so much, and I can't thank you enough for all of your continued support. Now, I'd like to thank you all for watching this video, and hope that you all enjoy today's content. If you feel like I deserve it, I'd appreciate the like and hope that you'll consider subscribing if you're interested in hearing from me again. I'll see you all in the next video, guys. And as always, take it easy.